What's the weird connection between The Walking Dead and Chicago Med? How did Colin Donnell's bad luck help him get onto the show? And who is the one actor from the Chicago universe that hasn't appeared on the medical drama? Let's scrub in.
I hope you find everything you want.
The Walking Dead is all about the people who can no longer be saved, while Chicago Med is the total opposite. Well, there's also no zombies in it, but anything can happen in the world of TV, right? Turns out there's another interesting connection between the two shows. Lori Holden has been earmarked to play a major character named Hannah Tramble, and she even appeared as Dr. Tramble in the backdoor pilot for Chicago Med. However, she exited the production just about as quickly as she joined it. In a statement, Lori said the following: "Sometimes we must make tough choices and, for family reasons, not doing Chicago Med is one of those for me at this time. I know the show's going to be a huge success and I'll be watching." After Lori's decision, the producers decided to not recast the role, but to create newer parts instead, which honestly makes more sense. And hey, who knows? Maybe in the future she could still show up on the show? One of the characters created to replace Dr. Tramble was Natalie Manning. She became extremely popular on the show, and fans were devastated when actress Tori DeVito left the series after season 7. However, Natalie almost wasn't Natalie at all. Thanks to some super sleuthing by Screen Rant, it was discovered that Natalie had a completely different name on her lab coat and early promo pics on the show.
What are you talking about?
If you look carefully at the image, it's clear to see that her original name was meant to be Lily. To date, it hasn't been revealed why she experienced the name change before the pilot, but it didn't have any real impact on the show either. After all, we met her as Natalie, and that's how everyone remembers her. And eventually, someone named Lily did appear later on, so no harm, no foul, right? Much like any good network show, Chicago Med features its fair share of romantic storylines. Well, to paraphrase the Wet 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 song, the love is certainly all around, even with the cast members. Did you know that Patty Murren and Colin Donnell are actually married in real life? Yep, the two actors tied the knot in 2015 after being engaged for 6 months. But you can't thank the show for bringing them together just yet, because they'd actually met on a film set a few years before Chicago Med. Though it certainly does help to keep everyone happy when you're filming and your partner's nearby. So while the doctors might have been dealing with patients who have heart complications on the show, the actors only have love in theirs in the real world. It's too cute, even if both of them have already left the show. But speaking of Colin, most fans will remember him from The Affair and Arrow. However, his role on Chicago Med actually came about thanks to a little bit of initial bad luck. Yes, you heard that right. Bad luck. Actors know that nothing is ever certain in their industry. They might go for an audition and never get a callback, or they could actually be cast in something that never sees the light of day. For Colin, it was the latter. In an interview, he revealed the following: "I'd done a pilot for NBC that wasn't picked up. The creators were putting together the cast for Chicago Med, and I was offered the role. So basically, Colin lost out on one part, but because of his good relationship with the network, he got another opportunity to work on one of the hottest shows on TV."
You know, put everything that's happened in the past underneath what's going on currently.
Hollyweird really does work in mysterious ways, doesn't it? Sometimes showrunners and producers make decisions that impact actors and take a positive stand on societal issues. Chicago Med's crew has been praised for how it treated the hair of black women, especially in the case of April Sexton, who was able to proudly show off her natural locks. For actress Yaya DaCosta, it was a breath of fresh air and actually made a huge difference in her own personal life. She revealed how hair treatments for a previous role resulted in her suffering from hair loss and major breakage before she got to play April. Speaking about the topic, she said the following: "I don't have to worry about someone accidentally leaving a hot iron on too long and that whole section of hair sticking to it and coming out. That's happened. All kinds of horror stories. I just feel so blessed to be with such a talented and knowledgeable crew." Now, these are the types of behind-the-scenes stories that make you smile and realize there are still people in the world who care about others. Many fans were delighted to hear that Brian T. had signed a brand new contract to continue appearing as Dr. Ethan Choi on the show. He's become hugely important to Chicago Med, and no one would want to see him depart like most of the main cast members. However, when the news broke that he'd be used sparingly in season 7, there were some questions about what was happening behind the scenes. As it turns out, Chicago Med, Brian, and Amazon's Expat series still had some negotiations to attend to.
It's the truest kind of reality.
Basically, what happened was the actor had been cast in Expats and still wanted to continue doing Chicago Med at the same time. With series naturally requiring more production time than a film, though, it was always like unlikely that Brian would have scheduling conflicts somewhere down the line. The good news is that the two shows worked together and figured out a way to make it work for everyone and ensure that he can still do both projects. See? It's true that teamwork makes the dream work. And speaking of work, a lot of effort goes into Chicago Med. In fact, the detail even extends to the actual episode titles. Pay close attention and you'll see that in season 1, the titles consist of only one word in them. In season 2, two words, and so on. Funny enough, another popular show, The Good Wife, also used this tactic for its episode titles. While it's a fun concept, it might get a little trickier when you go past season 10, because suddenly everything reads more like a sentence than an episode title. But the writers didn't think that one through and wrote themselves into a corner there. Everyone knows that anything is possible in the Chicago universe created by Dick Wolf. It's not unusual to see the actors cross the Great Divide and appear on the likes of Chicago Fire or Chicago Justice. However, there is one huge actor in the Chicago franchise who hasn't actually appeared on Chicago Med, much to many fans' surprise. And do you know who that is? It's John Seda, who plays Antonio Dawson. The actor has even appeared in Law & Order Special Victims Unit, but he's nowhere to be found in Chicago Med. Though considering how the medical drama is still ongoing, don't write off the possibility of John appearing as the fan-favorite character at some point. Maybe the producers are deliberately keeping him saved for a special storyline or occasion, because there's literally no way that he can stay away for too long, right?
Well, the stakes for an ED are always high.
Feeling like your brain is full of knowledge right now? Good. Because that means you're ready to be, fed some juicy facts about The Walking Dead now. Did you really think we'd feed you to the zombies? And while you're at it, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching, and stay awesome!